What's up, everybody? Teagan here with High Point Scientific. Thank you for tuning in to our full performance review on ZWO's latest and greatest cooled deep space imaging camera. The ASI533 monochrome camera is ZWO's latest and greatest deep space cooled imaging camera. From the position my telescope currently sits, I have a decent view of the northern to eastern skies. This gives me a lot to work with, but I am running out of objects to image in that region as I've been pointing my scope over there for the past 6 years. That being said, NGC 7000, or the North American Nebula, located within it is a beautiful hydrogen structure known as the Cygnus Wall. I'm going to be shooting the Cygnus Wall in narrowband through my 3-nanometer filters. So first things first, off with the old, on with the new. One of the great things about ZWO cameras is that they can be plug and play. I have my off-axis guider, my filter wheel, and my spacers already set up at 55 millimeters. All I need to do is remove the 294 and insert the 533 mono. So I'll be imaging NGC 7000 with my trusty 10-inch Newtonian. I'm all about that light gathering power and high resolution capabilities. I think the light buck is going to give me some awesome results. But first, let's talk about camera specs. Oh, that's great. So the 533 mono sensor is a 1-inch format camera sensor with a resolution of 3008 by 3008 pixels, meaning it is a square sensor. Some people like the fact that it's a square sensor because they say, you know, you don't have to do any framing, but I can attest to the fact that I did have to frame my target. I could not get the Cygnus Wall horizontal or vertical in my image. It had to be diagonal. So I did have to do some framing, but for most targets, you may have to frame. There is also no amp glow. Here's a 15-minute dark frame at high gain. Even the longest exposures are not going to produce any amp glow. So is there really even a point to dark frames? We'll find out in a bit. Now what this sensor is going to yield is a nice, clean, high-quality set of data. So like I said, the pixel size is 3.76 microns. So this is going to pair well with refractors at about 350 millimeters all the way to Newtonians or larger telescopes with a focal length of about 1200 millimeters. If you aren't sure if this camera is going to pair well with your telescope, look in the link below and we have an awesome article telling you how to pair your telescope's focal length with your camera's pixel size. That being said, let's move on to quantum efficiency. Quantum efficiency of this camera is 91%. That's in the O3 or the blue-green bandwidth, so still pretty efficient. And finally, this is a 14-bit ADC output, which is an improvement over the ASI 294's bin by one mode, the ASI 183, and the ASI 1600. Now it's time to test the camera. The first night out, I collected HA data and all went smooth. But on that second night, I had to split my night between O3 and S2 because of clouds. So there's no avoiding the fact that we will be doing a performance review with just a little bit of data, which may attest to the performance of this camera. I guess we'll see here in a bit when we review the data. So I took flat frames the morning after collecting my S2 and O3 data by pointing my telescope towards the sky and taking sky flats. Now I set my target ADU range to 20 to 30K, which is recommended for most CMOS cameras, but for whatever reason, it was overcorrecting. I had to reduce my ADU all the way down to 3000 for my flats to properly correct out my vignetting. I'm still trying to figure out why this is happening. If you guys have any insights, please let us know in the comments below. I'm sure it would help out anybody having this issue. My 3K ADU flats corrected out perfectly, and I have some seriously gorgeous data to work with, and I'm super excited to process it. Now, onto dark frames, and I did take dark frames, and I took them into my studio and to make sure that there was no light leakage whatsoever, as that's very important. We'll get to dark frames here in a bit and talk about if you even need to take dark frames with the 533 mono. But first, let's take a look at the data that I collected. Here in PixInsight, you can see the linear HA, O3, and S2 files. Once stretched, each stack shows zero signs of amp glow, and the flat frames at 3K ADU fixed any and all vignetting that I would have had. What you see here is a clean set of data, and this is really important for a couple of reasons. First, it saves time in post-processing. You don't want to be spending all of your time correcting for sensor modeling, insufficiently corrected amp glow, or vignetting and dust motes. And two, if you are a beginner looking for a dedicated imaging camera, the 533 is going to be easy to work with, and the sensor and the camera should provide you with some excellent results. Okay. Now let's talk about the dark frames. I took 15 600 second dark frames at negative 12 and at unity gain. I applied them to my HA, my O3, and my S2 stacks. Let's take a look at PixInsight and see what the results are. Okay, so here I have my O3 data. On the left side is with darks and on the right side is without dark frames. If I zoom in a tad on each side, I can see striations and banding on the image without darks, and I do not see that on the left side with the darks. If I move over to the sulfur data, on the left side is the frame with darks, on the right side is the frame without darks. Now immediately I see a little bit of banding, and the one on the right side just seems a bit more noisy. The one on the left side, the one with dark frames, does not have this banding, and the noise is, I would say, overall reduced quite well. Please ignore the stars. They are a bit out of focus. And finally, over here, I have the hydrogen alpha data. And if I zoom in here, this is the side with darks on the right and without darks on the left. And to be frank, I really can't tell a difference in the data over here. Again, this is an STF auto stretch. And my HA data looks the same with and without darks. It might be a tad smoother with the dark frames. So should you take dark frames with the ASI 533 mono? I would say go ahead and take your dark frames. I didn't see a difference in my HA signal. I also collected 6 hours worth of data. But in my S2 and my O3 data, I did see an improvement in noise. There was banding in both my S2 and my O3 data without dark frames. When I applied the dark frames, I didn't see that banding, and there was some reduction in noise. Now, I was able to stack and combine all 12 hours of SHO data, and I did produce a final image that still needs a little bit of work, but here are the preliminary results that I was able to achieve. Okay, so that is it for our ASI 533 monochrome full performance review. I had a fantastic time with this camera. It produced some really clean data that I really enjoyed working with. Again, if you have a refractor at about 350 to 400 millimeters focal length, or a longer focal length scope up to 1200 millimeters, anything in between that range is going to pair very well with the ASI 533 mono. So thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to like, subscribe so you don't miss any of our future content, and clear skies.